Alrighty, what's up guys? Speedy Mellow back for another lit video. Sorry if the audio was kind of wonky in this one, but we are currently recording in the bathroom because this is the only quiet spot I currently have in my house. Speedy Bro and Lil Speaks are fighting, so that's just fantastic. They're screaming, they are shrieking, and I'm not having that as a background. In this video, we're going to be going over 3 fantasy football teams and 2 fantasy basketball leagues. And then we got a couple of announcements at the end. One of those announcements includes explaining why I now have more teams to go over this week. But without any further interruptions, let's hop into the video. This is Team Jake, at FantasyGuy101 on TikTok's team. He got locked out of his account. So actually, no, I'm just going to explain as I get to the teams. He got locked out of his account for some reason, so I added myself as co-manager for him. He's just telling me what to do, so that he actually stands a chance. Mahomes didn't do great against the Falcons. That game was just terrible. 19.22 points, not great. Better than others. Dalvin Cook put up 16.5 against the Saints. 52-33. First time in NFL history that score has happened. At Cheese Man, you love it. Kamara cut sick. I didn't realize James Robinson was out. When I checked his lineup Sunday morning, it didn't say that, so whatever. Wouldn't have mattered, and I'll explain why a little bit. Justin Jefferson put up 14.5 against the Saints as well. Didn't have an awful game. If he got a touchdown, that would have been quite a bit more, but it's alright. Cole Beasley plays tonight in New England. Logan Thomas, he picked up this week, 13.5, and then Antonio Brown, 13.3 for Thomas, 13.5 for Brown. 49ers defense did pretty well against the Cardinals, allowed 12 points, a fumble recovery, and an interception, so pretty good. 9 points, and then Gostkowski only had the chance for 2 extra points against Green Bay in the 40-14 loss last night. So the current score is about 170-88 against Cheeseman. Here's why. Cheeseman started Alvin Kamara, who got 56.2 points in his 6 touchdown performance. Should have been 7, but whatever. 6 touchdown performance against the Vikings. Again, 52-33. First time in history that score's happened. He also started Mike Evans, who got over 40 points in the 47-7 win against the Detroit Lions. So, yeah, that's why it's not great. Also, my phone battery is low, so I hope I don't get kicked out at some point. All right, I'm going to pause the video, get another team, and then pick up in a second. Alrighty, we are back with my team in Jake's League. I was playing Kozo this week. Thought I was supposed to destroy him. I had a 66% chance of winning, and I am currently down by 30, and he still has a guy playing, so whatever. And I will explain my upsetness in a minute. Jalen Hurts put up 18.5 against the Cowboys. They lost by 20, but 18.5, that was the best quarterback I have. As you can see, Kyler Murray only put up 15. And then Drew Brees just sucked. Kenyon Drake had a decent game. 13 points against the... almost just fell, but braced myself, so I'm good. Against the 49ers, Le'Veon Bell, I picked him up thinking Clyde Edwards-Helaire was out, and that would be a great pickup. Turned out to be the stupidest pickup of the week. But again, we look down here, literally the best I could have done. Tyreek Hill, 10 points, not great. Put in Claypool, wouldn't have been better, so whatever. Calvin Ridley, he had a pretty decent game, putting together a solid 17 against the Chiefs. They almost won that game. Oh dear, that would have been amazing if Younghoe Koo had made that kick, sent it to overtime. Ugh. Also, I was tempted to start him, so it's a good thing I didn't. Cooper Kupp put... Oh wait, skipped Fant. Sorry about that. Oh, that was a real close game, Broncos. You tried your best, came up just a field goal short of the Chargers. In a 16-19 game, Fant put up 12.5. Cooper Kupp put up 14.5 in Seattle. I was so close to picking the Rams to just explode after their loss to the Jets, but that did not happen. Buccaneers defense, oh, how much I'm loving putting them in. 47-7. So 7 points allowed, an interception, a fumble recovery led them to 14 points. And then Bucker has 7. Eh, solid for a kicker. If I put in Carlson, who got 4 field goals, against the Dolphins. I lost a bet and ended up having to wear leggings for a whole day. Yeah, I did not vlog that one for a reason. I'm pausing the video again to get my third team, and then we'll be back. Alright, so I left the bathroom because it's really warm in there and I'm really hot. But here's my other team. I'm playing my uncle this week. And I'm currently down by, I believe, 40 with Diggs to play tonight, so I am going to lose. I'm in the loser's bracket, so it doesn't really matter, but still didn't want to end up last in the league, so whatever. Hurts got 35 in this league. Remember, stats are juiced. I knew putting in Jacobs was wrong. I was just praying that maybe I would get the upset, but no, I did not. But then Jonathan Taylor went out and doubled Jacobs, so it wasn't awful. He put up 26.5. Ridley put up 16. Not great, but not awful. Also, I was so close to putting in J.K. Dobbins, and I should have. But, hey, whatever. Kelsey put up 23, almost 24, so that's pretty good. Yeah, Diggs plays tonight. I don't think I said that, but whatever. Hill got 12.5. Eh, not great. If I had put in, if I put in Gibson instead of Jacobs and then Dobbins in the flex, would have been better. Buccaneers defense started them here to 24.5 points, solid. And then Justin Tucker came out and got 11.5 against the Giants. Here's why I didn't start Younghoeku. Negative half a point. I've never seen a kicker get negative points, but whatever. Congratulations on making it to the Pro Bowl. Let's now take a pause. And, well, not a pause, but we're just going to keep rolling. We're going to fantasy basketball now. We have the Baltimore Speedy Bros. This is my brother, Eli, and he is now locked out of his account as well, so I took over for him. He has Chris Paul, that guy, Jarrett, I think, something like that, Culver, Zion Williamson, something Adams, Terry Rozier, I'm going to guess. Something Grant, probably maybe John. So let's look. That's not how you spell Jeremy. Kevin Durant, Clark, Brandon. Yes. Oh, I got that right. Didn't look. And then Willie Cauley Stein. That's Cheese Man shooting me the snap. All right. Let's see. How did he do? If we go, you guys can see this information if you want. But yeah, right now I'm in first. I put up a solid 881 last week. Loved it. If we go to matchup 1, we'll see the Baltimore Speaky Bros beat A. Plotkin. That would be easy dubs, except he did not easy dub this week. 851 to 819. A very, very, very solid matchup. Clearly not as good as Team Wiseman against Principal Perry. That was 13-point differential. Pretty good. I'll just scroll through real quick. Team name still pending is in first at 947 points. I should have hit 900, but I forgot to set my lineup for Sunday. But whatever, I am in second. Let's get out of there. Take a look at my team, Team Mello. And here we go. We got Jrue Holiday. We got Draymond Green. Danny Green, close enough. Robert Covington, DeMontis Sabonis, Derek Favors, LaMelo Ball, Otto Porter Jr., Stephen Curry, Denny Avdia, Patrick Beverley, Andrew Wiggins, this guy, Ivica Zubac, definitely pronouncing that one wrong. We have Tim Hardaway Jr., we have Brandon, Bobby Portis, wow, okay. So yeah, as I said already last week, we won 881 to 677, right? 881 to 657. Oh, come on, really? All right, whatever. All right, let me real quick show you the announcement. So if you're on the app, go into message board. Look at this. We already need to talk about trading. I'm going to read it to you guys. This is a warning to everyone. If you're proposing a trade, make sure it benefits both people in the trade. I will not be naming names, but there have been traded, meant to say trades. There have been trades where one person benefits and the other does not. I see all trades. If I see a trade in which it is a scam, you will be kicked after one warning. There have been scams. I'm really getting sick of it. Do not do that. I will kick you this is your warning. If you do it once, that's your warning. Do it again, you're gone. And if I see something bad, I will alert the team that did not benefit from that to reconsider next time they make a trade and make sure it's all right for them. And we have another trade. I'm going to be doing a video in which I... Since I'm not going to spoil it. Coming soon, though. There will be no. Maybe it'll be a live stream. I might live stream it. No, not going to live stream it. It's just going to be a long video, alright? I'm going to be going onto Instagram. I'm going to be messaging different teams throughout the major four sports, the major four conferences, which would be baseball, so MLB, football, and NBA, football, NFL, basketball, NBA, and then we have hockey, the NHL. Also, let me know down below, do you guys want me to start a fantasy hockey league? I literally know zero about hockey. I can maybe name two teams, the Blues, the Flyers, the Capitals, the Penguins, of the Kraken. Aren't they the new team? I don't know. So yeah, let me know down below if you would be interested in fantasy hockey. If you do, I will be more than happy to open a league. But that's essentially going to do it for today's video. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the post notifications. Tell your friends about these videos. I'm losing my voice on this video. Send help. And you and I, I'm going to see you in the next video. Be sure to light them up. Peace! That was Matthew Stream from the other one.